filming again. The camera just turned off. So we're just starting up another third video of just what happened with Hohepa Epiha and myself today on the 11th of April 2016. I've just been talking to Peter Paraoni. He's the chairman of the Waitangi National Trust over in the Top Marae, and I've got to put something in writing to him. You see, these take forever to go from one person to another. I'm glad to have Hohepa Epiha, the Taumata Kaumatua from Ngāti Kura Marae in Matari Bay, to help to put their Ngāpui Nui Tono together and make them use their flag. This flag's got the most power in it, in the world, and yet the government here has trying to get rid of the Union Jack flag and put a fern flag up. You see, this and the TPPA agreement, and this flag here has got more than that going. Oh, here he is. Yeah, hello.
Hey, John.
Yeah.
I've got Matua from Tongaroo on.
Okay.
He's, I haven't filled him in at all, purely because I was just about to take time to have a bit of lunch.
Okay, yeah, me too, afterwards.
And then he's run, but I don't want to take this opportunity away from him.
Yeah.
Because he's one of the icons of the Taumata.
Right.
And I wanted every attention with him.
Right.
Matua Wurumu here will always be, this is how I see it, Matua Wurumu. Peter is the Kaumatua of that area who will have continued dialogue with me and on behalf of the Kaumatuas of Hokianga.
Yes.
Not just of Rone Pamuru, but of Hokianga. And that he will translate all that dialogue as far as we are concerned. For us to get some leadership there, and so I don't have to go ringing every Tom, Dick and Harry.
Yes.
That, you know, the mana of that area must be given to that a person over there to translate all that quarter.
Right.
Likewise, when I talk to Rockwell here, I talk to Nukianu.
Yes.
And if you want up the top, I talk to Joe Everett.
Yes.
So all those sort of. Now I've got Matua Wurumu on at this moment.
Okay.
Wurumu. Matua Wurumu. Before I put you on to John, during my discussion this morning, I was talking to Peter Brownlee, and I felt that with all the dialogue that's taking place, with Winston Peters is starting to catch up on these fellows, on John Key and them, I thought it was appropriate for us to have that internal dialogue with him, and that Peter would have been the right person for me to talk to, purely because he's the chairman of the Marae up in Waitangi there, and for us to gain entry in those areas there, he must perhaps can give us a lead in to how we can start the process off. Now, all these other stuff here, I'll pass it on to John, because John is talking about a date that the Taumata, and that's this week. So I'll hand you over to John, eh? Okay.
Kia ora, Willie. Good to hear you again. So at this present moment, I've been cleared to go in on the Marae Titi and have the hui there.
Can you hear him?
To have the hui there, and so it's taken a load off my shoulders for the cost of hiring the Marae. because I now can just go there for the pōwhiri on Thursday at 10 o'clock in the morning, and then from that the next day is 5 o'clock in the top marae to go there for the flag procession. But I'm waiting for the Navy to clear that little process. But we've also got the marae there open for us from 5 to 7 o'clock to actually address the whakaputanga itself in there from a point in time of the 182 years that it's been flying with the British. And that was that hui over in Kororareka, 1834 side of the flag that we're having the hui for before John Key tries any more tricks. We need to make a stand to make the public aware and also the government aware that we are starting to use this flag for what its reason is, commerce and bank and everything else, Willie. So I've been talking to Peter directly, and I've got to put something in writing to him to effect the hui on Friday, the main day being Friday, 5 o'clock in the morning, and I wanted this flag raised. At the moment, the top marae has opened the gate for us. It's let us go to the flagpole, and it's opened the door to go into the whare to make a statement to the British government that we still have a partnership with this flag going on, right? It's not lost. And that's the part we don't want any more threats on the land. The only way to do was to force the issue. And with what Hohepa's doing now, rounding them all up, the more show of support from the Ngāpuhi Nui Tonu for this part of the flag is very important, with more voices to go into that whare and stamp their mark on that whare, not the lower house, the other side, to make the point that it belongs to Ngāti Kaua and Ngāti Rairi Hapu, and not the government or the trustees. And so you've got to make the flag own the whole place to Britain and tell Britain, I write a letter for the elders and the taumata kaumatua to send to the British government and military to say this flag needs to be legalised to our mana to use on any more threats. They're drilling holes in the seabed right now on the East Coast. They're letting that go now, Simon Bridges, and that's starting to worry me down the East Coast for the first time. And Winston Peters and his challenge on the Panama is what we need to do with this flag, with Peter Peroni or anyone that's going to support going our own way. Okay?
John?
Yeah.
John? Have you started putting that letter together?
No, I'm just waiting for the response from the marae and from you fellas, and then I will action it with Peter Peroni, because him being politic, to push the issue as far as Maori is concerned. Where the hell do they sit? In the middle of their land. Because of John Key's interest in his own business. And he's not there for us. The Navy, if the Navy don't turn up, they are not there for us. And that's what I'm trying to force out. Who is there for us? The Hapu.
Yeah. So, having said that, would it be okay for you to start putting that letter together now?
I am.
Oh, good on you.
I am, because it's urgent. It's urgent. That's why we have this week. It's got to have a time date on it. The 15th is the time date to start from this point. 182 years has gone by since the 10th of March 2016. From the 10th of March 1834, it's been exactly 182 years, nothing has happened with this flag for us.
Yeah.
So we don't want another, we need to renew the contract with Britain. Because it's a British flag. It's a British flag that gives us the right to go around the world, but we've got no ship.
Yeah.
I'm trying to raise the interest from the people to make this flag what it's supposed to be, a trading bank flag. Not a football flag. It's more powerful if we got it started.
Yeah.
Yeah. With the start date for this flag to start using it is the 15th in Death Marae on the other side. Not King East on this side, the other one.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No wonder Charles Hohepa is using that flag for his own bloody...
That's right. He knows what to do with it. If I did what he did, I'd be screaming ahead, but I'm not, because I'm there to get them in get the taumata and the kaumatua elders in place to in numbers. In their numbers, that's the, because they know the mana comes from the elders, not from the individual. Yeah? It won't work without that. It won't work with one man.
Yeah.
So that's the only way to do it, to make a statement. We're going to make a statement from inside that marae that I shall write what you shall say and what we all shall do with this flag to make it work for us.
Well, that's one of the things that I, if you can remind me at Waitangi, then I'll put the homie at to it.
Yeah.
Hey, Wurimu? That John will be designated to be the scriber for that letter to be written.
Yeah.
To be sent away forthwith, and with the homie behind it. Everything got to have that homie
in the house.
In the house.
It's a clean house. It's a clean house.
Yeah. And I'll have Pastor Ricky to do the resolution. It's your name. You stand as the subject. Okay, John?
Mm.
You stand as the subject. And once that's done, you then have the mana to go ahead and provide that letter.
Yeah, because the thing is this, the flag is flying there on the crossbar.
Yeah.
It's flying there, but right in the right marae. Yeah. We are lucky they gave us the marae to go and do it.
Yeah.
Yeah. We got through the gate. We got at 5 o'clock in the morning. We got through the gate. We got so 2 hours to do it.
Have you spoken to Machu Wurimu on our days that are coming?
Yeah. I just told him the Puhi on Thursday, 10 o'clock. That's to be respectful to the whare, but the main issue is the flagpole on the other side.
Yeah.
Yeah, the whakaputanga is on the other side. The whakaputanga is that ship on the land, the ship. That's the commerce, that side that I'm taking care of with your followers over there.
That's a topic, Wanamu?
That's the other ship.
It's on the other side. You've got to get off the ferry to go across it.
Yeah, that's the other ship, that settlement. When they first came here, the first mortgage was there with that ship, and then they kicked this other one off. That was 1834 there on the 10th, and on this side was the 28th of October at Waitangi there. So the two ships are what forms their instruments for making money out of everybody.
Yeah.
Mm.
So I'll say it again, Wanamu, on Thursday, I'd be grateful if you can come on Thursday at 10 o'clock and to a pōwhiri, but you as one of the taumata will be going straight into the door as long as we get there before 10 o'clock. So if you, Boxer, and the other ones can come, even Hohepa, if that's okay with you, if not, give me a call just to update me by at least 6 o'clock.
Bye.
Okay. Oh, okay. He's on the phone, John. Singing me from Tamaki. So it's a cost factor that he's got at this moment.
No, cost factor.
Well, the other one is that he's unlikely to be coming because daughter's got in a heart operation.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, and he's up in Auckland at the moment. He's over there in Auckland.
Oh, right.
I'm very sorry to hear about that. Wait, do you know? What's his name? We'll pray for him tonight, mate.
9-year-old.
Okay, man. These are some of the things that I start to tear because our young ones haven't got a chance, or well, got a very slim chance. Even if they come through the process, they are facing a lot of challenges at this moment where we haven't done any good cleaning up, and whereas we should be leaving this house in good order and good state for these fathers. But never mind. We'll all keep rubbing on and making sure that things are all right. But for this point in time, what we'll do is go ahead and do this. But if you can ring Joe and them up, and if they can do it, give him my number, and I'll get them to call me up, and I'll confirm the process for them.
The kid, 99.
Yeah.
Yeah, hell.
There's life and there's life.
Yeah.
Life in terms of the singular and the growing up of a person, and life, that's what happens during your period while you're here on earth.
Yeah.
You go through the process. And some will fall short, others will go on, and they've been told, hey, you know, too old to be still hanging around.
Catch the next bus out.
Buckle.
And I'm just saying, why has it been so hard? Why is it so hard? Somebody's making it hard, eh? Just one or two people making life hard for us.
Can you see me?
Yeah, I can see you. So that'll be good. Then we're getting some traction, and I'm hoping I can check my mail afterwards to see if the Navy has sent a email yet. And so that's all I was waiting for.
Okay, John, I'm going to say this. You've only been with me just a couple of hours or
yeah.
so, and what I've done is created some dialogue so that we can get in people that you and I know of
yeah.
and you and I can rely on.
Yeah, rely on. That's a word.
And these are the people that will give traction
yeah.
to what the dreams and aspirations we're all about.
Yes, yes.
Further than that, if we continue to wait and wait and wait,
and wait yeah.
then that song will come up.
Yes.
Why are we waiting? But seriously, on a serious note, I think the 1, 2, 3 letter is sufficient for them to say, for you to say, as long as you can date those letters and have somebody to send it or sign it and have it sent away, keep a copy, then you can move on in the next step without waiting for the response.
Yeah, yeah.
You can say, and in your letter, you know, we are hoping that we can get this response by that date because we want to proceed in this endeavor and to ensure that we will all celebrate a good outcome. Once they fail in that, it'll be up to our jurisdiction to say, well, we're sent it the Māori way, we've called you, and the Mākehā way will send you some letters.
Yeah.
And 1, 2, 3 letter. And the third one is that, well, it's time to move on.
Move on, yeah. So yeah, so that's what I'm saying. As long as we physically start doing something with the flag, then they can see us doing something with it. Yeah, it's very important. Otherwise, it's nothing happening. We've got to make it legal.
Is that we caught you coming?
I'll call him. Yeah, he said he's coming.
Yeah.
He did say he's coming because anything with a flag, he's there.
Yeah. But if you give him a call, tell him they expect us there.
Yeah.
And Kosai will be talking to him.
Yeah. Yeah.
The other thing is please make contact with Kenny.
Yeah, no, I'll call him. I'll call him after. I'll call him after. Now that we've got this far. And to make sure the outcome is good. Yeah. The outcome is good. I can talk to him and just make sure that the things happen.
Oh, I can talk to him, but I don't want to talk to him because I'm actually highly pissed off with him.
Yeah.
When he walks out on the marae, especially in Māpui, he doesn't realize that it's him that's losing. Because all the kaumatuas over there were thinking alike. He said when a person removes himself, he's removing his hapu.
Yeah.
It's not just himself, it's his hapu that's missing out on all the kōrero.
Yeah.
Now, the turmoil is happening in his marae. They don't know which is, they are wakaputanga people.
Yes.
Or they are government people in terms of trustees.
Yes.
And he can't wrestle with them.
Yeah.
He don't know how to wrestle with wakaputanga either.
Yeah, yeah. So it's a pity, really, because if you use a marae how it's supposed to be used, you'll be getting lots of out of it.
Hell yeah.
You know?
Here's the analogy. I don't know what I spoke to you about it before, that the trustee will talk about having to have $2,000-something for the amount that you were talking about.
Yeah.
If that is the case, then I'm guessing only people that would have that money will have that way there.
Yes.
In doing so, say 10 times of the year, they'll get 20,000.
Yes.
Right? Now, from the other viewpoint, you've got a koha that'll come up to about $400 to $800 maximum. $800, but the amount of people that'll go there, they will see what the kōrero is and the places.
Yes.
Some of them come from Sweden, some Netherlands, from overseas. And they said, man, what a beautiful place. And that, then they come to the Kaupapa and they're blown away.
Yeah.
They'll gather up some people to come back again.
Yes.
And the doors to those marae will stay open because, in my view, they will have one person, two, three people employed there, one pōwhiri, one to do the me, and the other one to do a waiata. They can do that with being employed.
Yes,
being employed,
yeah.
And $800 times how many times of the year they would make a visit, they can get up to about 500 visits. 500 times collectively times 200 people.
Yes.
Wow, look at that.
Yeah, yeah.
They're missing out on the economic side from a Māori perspective.
Yes.
From a Māori perspective. Whilst they are being so fucking lazy.
Yes.
And counting on the system to pay for their things that they are not doing right.
Yes, yes.
Because it's not about kōmātou. They are saying, oh, it's only us, singular.
Yes, yes.
They believe in what is it? Singular? Individualization?
Yes, yes. Yes.
That word pops up like I'm Dr. Hohepa. So that's the difference between people knowing what the bloody will do.
Yes.
To people that are so lazy that they hang on to something that's there as long as it's there. Those people over there are subjugating them to do. You do what I'm telling you because I'm giving you the money.
Yes, yes.
Yeah. And the money is the accountability. We can do the same thing on this side and multiply that by 500. You understand what I'm saying?
Yeah, no, I know what you're saying. I know what you're saying.
You accept what I'm saying.
I'm only always looking at a lost opportunity on a marae. When it's spoiled and people say, oh, I come all this way to listen to that.
Yeah.
Yeah?
Waitangi is a center point of the world in terms of Aotearoa is concerned.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know, even down in Parliament, they're talking about the Treaty of Waitangi. And the Harlequin don't even know where the fucking treaty is.
Yeah, yeah. So they wanted to shift the focus away from Titi because it looks too violent in front of all the world.
That's the one.
That's what they said. It doesn't look like a good look.
Yeah.
Yeah. And they're thinking of, well, Shane Jones said, you know, shift the thing. And so he's poking his finger back in again to try and make something work for Maori. And Peter Peroni could be, and Winston could fire up this whole thing.
Yeah.
You know, they could get the marriage going if only they start talking to each other.
Yeah.
I can only see you making that happen. I can't see it anywhere else.
Yeah, well, I'm really thinking very hard for the winter period for me to do that.
Mm.
It's winter minimum to get Calvin Davis in them. All those ministers to come in and listen to the corner and wrestle with themselves, and then get an outcome according to what the taumata is instructing them to do.
Yeah, yeah.
Rather than the Pākehā bastard telling them to have to suck eggs.
Yeah, so because they're even spoiling. They're spoiling all the kohanga reos and all the young people.
Yeah.
They're going haywire because they don't care about anything with Māori. They just throw them on the street.
It's hekia parata in them.
Yeah, hekia parata. Ngāti pro.
Ururoa.
Yeah, ururoa. They talk too fast. They talk too fast and you know, its commercial wheels are falling off.
Yeah.
Huh? The commercial wheels are falling off and still haven't done much for Māori.
Yeah.
Yeah. And someone's getting rich by someone who's getting poor. That's what I'm saying. I've only got one shot at trying to get something going. Otherwise, people are saying, well, how long are you waiting for these blooming tidal turbines? I said, oh, hang on, won't be long. I'll just have another crack at it and see if we can get something going for our people first.
Yeah. See? Actually, I'll try and see if I can find Steve Mortimer. Keep talking.
Yeah, I'm hoping that we can get, before Wednesday, we can get something positive. With the marais, and I'm still, even if we don't get the flag up, it's still a hui on the other side.
Hello, how are you? You come back all right from down Queenstown? Oh, good on you. This is Matua Hohepa here. Kei ana koutou. Ai, tēnā koe Matua, pē ana koe. Ai, pē ana tērā takiwā ngaitahu. We missed the both of you. it can be seen. Hapo poto to tatu wa tutaki tai tanga, ka kite no te tai o tatu, e te rā tūnonga pātū e maroa. Ka tai atu tō mātu waiwa i na tui o mātu karapia, kia manawhi te akoutou. So we had a good time at Otawa. We had our arataki that are got on Skype here, John Wanoa from Auckland. He's on Skype with me talking about a case that's going to come up, why I wanted to ring you. E kōrero Pākehā ki tūna ki a koe na ki a mohi o mai e ia. Nō reira whaia. This is if you are available at 10 o'clock on Thursday, we got the Puhi taking place at Waitangi. Before 10 o'clock, the taumata will be in the house down the bottom on the taumata of Mapuhi Nuitonu. It's not just of Ngāti Kau and Ngāti Rahiri. Because the Kaupapa is about Te Wakaputanga and the flag. So it becomes a united one there. And it's at 10 o'clock on Thursday. We will have the Puhi at the marae. And then inside there, it's about some small discussion that John will put together and start talking about some preliminary actions to take to be ka haumie hui e te tatu. Pēne o tai ngā reta e tuku nā tūna nei e ia. Ka kōrero te ia ki whoever he sendi nā reta to. Name me where, John?
That will go to the British government.
It'll go to the British government.
Yeah, and the Navy. The Navy.
And another one to the Navy. Because I'll let John give you a reason why that is, and you'll hear him talk.
Yeah, so this is what is happening. We had permission to go into the top marae and to go to the flagpole and address the whakaputanga. And then go into the whare of the treaty house and have a locked-in time memorial of 182 years. It's taken for this flag to be flying with the Navy here. Supposed to be there for us. They are not there for us because I've written three letters to them. And I'm waiting for a letter today to come and help us to put this flag up the top of the mast on the pole, and to bring the New Zealand flag down on the crossbar. We still have a relationship with the British military that I've written to, and it's crucial we do something with the flag, because John Key has already had an attempt to replace the flags with his football flag, and if he would have succeeded, it would have put a lot of strain on this whakaputanga and taking the mana out of it. If we didn't do something, this is the best time to do it in that whare next to the flagpole. And that's why they've locked it all out so we can't get to it. And they've agreed, the marae committee has agreed for us to go in there and have a service, and to start the process off with a document for us to start using this flag, because somebody's using it to make a lot of money out of it for their business. And that'll happen to be the government still using, and the Navy still using this flag for some reason or another. The Kaumatua and the Taumata of Nui Tonu, Ngāpui, need to find out for the next 182 years what the role of the flag is going to be for the Hapu than anybody else. Okay?
That sounds good to me.
Yeah, so this is what this Kaupapa is about, us, you people, the elders, to claim its usefulness while it's still there, and while it doesn't get the TPPA or drilling holes in the seabed and everything, this flag has got power to Britain to help us now, because the police are not there for us. Now the Navy is not there for us. The government's not there for us. Therefore, it's the responsibility of the British government to address our issues direct. So I'm writing a letter from inside that whare with the taumata there and the kaumatua elders to action the use of that letter with Peter Baroni now knowing what is going on.
Okay, this is what we've had in our discussion since this morning, and I've rung Peter to get those connections and those sort of things in regard. But the issue for you and I is to make ourselves available at 10 o'clock at the marae in Waitangi. And I'll ring you back again, say about Wednesday, just to confirm, because I need Hone to have us in there and for him to speak to Kingi. He needs to talk to Kingi to give him a rundown of the process that we're going to come there for. It's not about just Kingi, it's about all of us. And I think a separate... I was contemplating the kaupapa for us to get neutralized along with Ngāti Rahiri and Ngāti Kaua. Because the kaupapa belongs to Ngā Puhi Nuitunu. However, the mana whenua still holds the principal mana to that area. So it's about to whakanoa us down there first before we get on that taumata. To be part of Ngāti Rahiri, or for Ngāti Rahiri to be part of Ngā Puhi. Ke reira ke era kōrero e hanga I ana, and I need to know that with Kingi, so that I can, we can have, then have that pathway in meeting up in Waitangi. Now, I'll instruct John to do that, and to make sure that Kingi's got it right, so that we can go in there feeling quite neutralized that the kaupapa isn't what Ngāti Rahiri and Ngāti Kaua, but it's the Ngā Puhi Nuitunu. Pai ana tēnā? Okay, Matua, I will leave you for now, and I'll get back to you again on Wednesday to confirm all these things. Whaia, love you, whaia.
Kia ora.
Nō ora, mate. There you go.
Very good. You're a very good postman. You're a good chief.
All my life I've been managing hotels.
Yes.
I've been coordinating and facilitating meetings.
Yeah, yeah, I can see that.
So I know the processes to just clearing the way and getting things underway.
Yes.
And it may not be a lily white, but it's getting to that direction, you know.
He looks all right to me.
So the issue for us is don't get mad when things change to custard.
Yes.
You know, Rome wasn't built in a day.
Yeah, yes.
So we've got to keep harrowing.
Yes.
For me and Kingi, I've got to say to you, that my wairua is not right with him yet, since he walked out.
Yes.
But I'm also saying that I still love the man. Mm. There's times that he can, it is to all of our benefit that we need to start talking about loving one another.
Mm. Mm.
Because the tika and the whanau will follow love.
Mm.
And love is the pinnacle, as I was saying. Did I say that?
Mm, mm.
It's a principal word to freedom.
Yes. One step for mankind.
You like that?
Yeah, I like that.
You like that, technology.
One, yeah, I like what you said. One step for, one great big step for mankind.
Yes.
Yeah.
Oh, no, I didn't say that.
I added it.
Principle to love is the principle, the epitome to love is the outcome of it is freedom.
Freedom, okay.
Freedom. So, okay. Whether you tell porkies,
yeah.
You still tell that story because you have the freedom of choice.
Choice, yeah.
Whether to tell the truth or not.
Yes.
But if you don't tell the truth, everything will turn to custard.
Yes, yes.
Because in the end, it's supposed to be freedom.
Freedom, yeah.
But you know, you have that poor thought.
Yeah.
They're saying that you're only painting the law to suit you.
Mm.
I'm not talking about you. I'm referring to Kingi.
Yes. Yes.
It's no good him doing the same things if he's behind the corner he's about your daughter.
Yes, yes. Yes.
And that's why I'm saying, you know, I'd rather masturbate than you taking that out on a woman. No, not that I do that. But the outcome of it is that I want you, in terms of your request, my request for as Arataki, is to make contact with Kingi, let Kingi know that the taumata is coming.
Yes.
On Lapui, and that they would like to sit with him.
Yes.
Yes.
It doesn't matter whether it's on that seat or whether it's around. The taumata will be coming.
Okay, so I'll give him a ring. I'll give him a ring in a minute.
Yeah, and then from there, we will be meeting before 10 o'clock, hopefully.
Yes.
About half past nine.
Right.
We want to go in the house at half past nine.
Right.
Ready to start at half past nine at the neutralizing or whakanoa from Ngāti Rahiri, Ngāti Kawa, to all the other chiefs.
Yes.
Of Hapu is neutral, that there needs to be a neutralizing.
Neutralizing, okay.
Alright?
Yep, I'll do that.
And then we become united with the kaupapa, not the whare.
Yes, with the kaupapa. All right. Yep, yeah,
the
whare, okay.
They still own the mana of the whare.
Yes.
But the kaupapa is set for Hapu is neutral. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I know what you're saying.
You better tell them what I'm telling you, otherwise you...
No, I got it. He
doesn't like the word instruction, but that's the truth of it.
Okay, I'll give him a call and I'll let you have some lunch.
Okay.
And then I'll get on with it.
Thank you, mate.
Okay, cheers. Well, there you go. Another long video. Oh boy, this is really, really something. I'm going to ring Kingi while I'm here. Oh. Not there. Anyway, I was just trying to ring Kingi to talk to him what's just gone on. It's been a busy morning with Hohepa. It's a lot of organising to get a hui going, and already it's turning out into quite a few people going, and I'm yet to hear back from the Navy. This is supposed to be a video for the Navy. Now I've got to make another one. Sorry about that, Joe, Shannon. I was making a video for you, but it's turned out into a long one. In fact, it's turned out into three videos. No, there's no email from the Navy yet, or from the Marae. So I've let them know that I'm not taking the Marae. But we will see what the Marae is going to do, Te Te Marae, if they're going to be there, if all these Ngāpuhi turned up, the elders, which at this point in time, I've got to make sure I've got the War Memorial Hall to go to have at least a hui, if anything is not turning out to be in the marae, as for this whakaputanga flag, it's important. I wish I had my own marae now so that I can get everything done quickly, but that's not possible and it's not my flag to say anything about it. So I'm just a little frustrated with things are so slow in making progress, and I thank Hohepa Epiha for putting up with all of this again. I was scribing for him and it was taking a long time just to get it off the ground last year to help him and his gathering of the Ngāpuhi Nui Tonu, which is fractured over the time period in the last 3 to 4 years that I've been going to the marae, that I wanted some closure so we can get on with this flag and start doing some work. And I'm anxious to get the projects going with the Moai King William Party and also the trust that we have set up with the share company. It'll be going where it's going to go, and not wait around if it's going to take too long. So I think that'll be all for now, because I've got 3 long videos to upload, and we'll leave it there and get on with it. So thank you very much. Today is Monday, the 11th of April 2016, John Wanoa, Auckland, New Zealand. Bye for now.